start with the body number chart, body four. So, till here, anybody has any questions?
Different sages and rishis are saying the same thing from simple thing, simple way to complex.
Absolutely.
Why is this ego of the mind stuff, egos, one of the most difficult things not to follow a simple instruction?
We are born out of the ego. And there is only one scripture that really teaches this in depth, and that's the Yoga Vashishtha. Yeah? Yoga Vashishtha is the scripture of Lord Rama's enlightenment, his journey of enlightenment. And Vashishtha was his guru. And Rama asks a lot of questions to Vashishtha. And in that entire process, Vashishtha tells you that you were born out of your ego. The ego is born first. Then that ego gives birth to the mind, the intellect, the memory. And from that desire arises. From that desire, the body is created. So, what is the root?
Ego.
Yeah. So, on the way back, I have to start dropping that mind, that intellect, that memory. And finally, the last thing that will drop will be
ego.
The ego is going to fight the hardest, na? It's his existence. It is his baby. This is his baby. This body is his baby. This life that is created is the ego's baby. How is he going to give up so easily? It's the ego's fight. Yeah, he's fighting. Till that time you keep fighting with the ego, you will not win. You will not win by fighting. Yeah? How do you win? By being quieter and quieter. Only silence kills the ego. Your fighting does not kill the ego. Only silence can kill the ego. And how does it do it? The silence makes the self stronger and makes the ego weaker and weaker and weaker. It's like its power starts getting discharged because you choose to be in silence rather than in the fight. Do you get it? And that silence makes the self so strong that one day the ego has to give up. But remember, the last fight is the strongest fight. Yeah, that last fight is like kushti. Come, let's see who's stronger. That's how the ego will be. It's called the attack of Maya. It happens on the spiritual path at the last point. But to be able to combat that, you need a lot of silence. Like, silence is like you are collecting a treasure. The more the silence increases, the more my treasure, my ammunition and arms increase. And the weaker the ego is becoming. When the time is right, that's when you strike. One blow and the ego's gone. But for that one blow, you have to practice a lot of silence. Plus, the effort is only there. Only in that much. The rest of it is effortless. It's just being in silence is required. If you can't do it on your own, you go to a course. Yes? But if something helps you at home also, start going into silence. Increase that. Become more and more and more quieter. Turn inwards. Turn inwards. Turn inwards. Then otherwise people make it a ritual.
Yeah.
Once a year only I'm going to be silent. The rest, 362 days, I'm going to talk and bug the people around me. What's the point? In 3 days I'm going to be silent. It's not going to work. Bring this into your life. Let this become your nature. Then only have you applied it. Otherwise, what are you doing? Yeah?
then we are born, we have babies, like maybe a month, 2 months, a year. At that time also we have an ego.
So out of ego only you have again chosen to come back. Yeah. But initially the baby is also baby ego. It's not so big yet. There is more innocence than ego. Yeah, but you start learning. When I scream, mommy gives me food. When I scream, I get that toy back. So you start screaming. That's how the baby ego starts growing. And then when you take that toy away, then I scream, it'll come back. You see, that starts happening. Oh, if I just hit mommy like that, then she'll give it back to me. So that's where you start learning. Ego is acquired tactics. And I use them throughout my life. And they are acquired only in this body. That is why when this body dies, everything was acquired with this body, no? And it's trying to get back that body. And that acceptance is not there at the time of death. And that ego wants to get back into the body. It wants to, you know, hug the child again. It wants to sit at the table and eat again. It wants to be in its house, but it's gone. It takes about 3 days for this ego to stop this and then accept and die.
Here I say like, I'm superior, that's an ego, right? But that again is a thought, and these thoughts and emotions are being created, right? So that gives us this ego is also being created.
Yes. You pump your ego, means that ego is becoming bigger and bigger. You puncture the ego, it becomes puss. It does not exist really. Otherwise, how can you puncture it? It's fake. It's a fake belief. It's a fake I. It thinks this body and this mind is what is I. And I should just strive to let this body progress in the material world. That is the way ego functions. At death, what happens? The material world is only taken away from you. The end. So, ego is like a fish out of water. How long is that fish going to live? It's going to chatpata, 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 when? Finished. And goes. Before death kills you, you die. What does it mean? Commit suicide? No. He's saying this ego, when it surrenders, it does samarpan. That's the moment you die. That life after the death of the ego is real life. It is so beautiful. It's like blossoming of a flower. There is fragrance everywhere. Nobody can touch you. Nothing can touch you. Because you're not holding on anymore to this material world. Nothing is mine anymore. So then there is nothing that grasps, that grasping, holding, that chinna, jhapatna, all that has gone away. Your open fists, all yours, sab tera, sab tera, sab tera. Very easy to live life like this, very easy. Because boss, I am not fighting only, I have quit the fight. I don't want to fight anymore. How much ever you punch, punch, keep punching, you're punching thin air. I am not standing up to fight only. Are you getting it?
But is it right to say it dies? Or you can use it as an instrument when needed?
Yeah, you will use it as an instrument.
So it doesn't die really.
See, who's asking this?
So is it related to the ego and self-respect are related? Are they same?
That's because we have confused that ego is equal to self. A person who is not on the spiritual path and who writes that English dictionary for you, then you have gone and rattled that dictionary and used those words. These are just words for convenience. So simple. You have confused the self with the ego. Yes, different. And really, you can operate out of the self. You don't need even that little ego to operate. This is what I want you to start tasting by being in the isness. This gives you the confidence that being established in that silence, in that isness, I can still operate, I can still do things. That's when you drop the ego totally. Yeah? It'll die. Finally, it has to die. Abhi thoda thoda you're letting it die. But like I said yesterday, it's like a lizard that will grow its tail again. So don't keep that little also pau kilo ego that you want to use as a tool. In the end, even that pau kilo has to die. Pau kilo is 250 grams of ego. You can't keep even that much. Even that has to die in the end.
Yesterday, we were doing somebody down. I really came into like a wall. You know, like I couldn't write anymore. And there was nothing that was coming, you know. And I tried to find something. And I could literally picture my ego as a huge wall, you know, a very strong wall that wouldn't allow me to even write one.
Beautiful. How many of you experience the ego as a big wall? Beautiful. You have hit on a very big realization.
So I went home and I started trying to find the purpose. I said, what is the purpose of ego? And I kept digging it. And then I said, okay, ego is the first layer of existence. Maybe the purpose there. But then I started going, okay, through all the other layers. I could see a reason for the body, you know, I could see a purpose for that. I could see a purpose for the breath. I got stuck with the mind. I couldn't see a purpose for the mind. I could see intellect, memory, I could see a purpose for those. But for the ego and the mind, I couldn't. So I'm a very visual person. So what came to me was, okay, ego is the gatekeeper of that consciousness that escaped. But then I was still stuck with the mind. What is the purpose of the mind? What came to me was the mind, the purpose of the mind is to purify itself so it can ego to get back to where it was. But I think I couldn't have even seen that if I hadn't felt that wall yesterday. So I could almost see it now. You know, it's like waking up.
Yes. Did you realize that the mind is pretty useless? Very, very clear about it.
And it's purified.
Yes, absolutely. So there is no pure mind. It is called no mind.
No.
Are you ready to drop the mind?
No.
That's it. Your journey has begun. This happens. This is the first step, self-inquiry. I didn't give this homework to you. It happened naturally to me. Self-inquiry on your own, that thirst propels you to start going deep within and seeing who am I. This started with that question. Guruji planted that seed in you in the video when he said, you start with who am I. In one sentence, he didn't say anything more. Just that one thing of the master, one word of the master she took and she started looking with him. That seed started sprouting and gave her the answer. You go within, start your journey. Look within. Anybody else wants to share something? Can I go to body char? Body char. Sacha Sahib Sach Nai.
Sacha Sahib Sach Nai.
Akhiya Pau Apar.
Akhiya Pau Apar.
Akhi Mangi De De.
Akhi Mangi De De.
Dat Kari Data.
Dat Kari Data.
Fir Ke Agge Rakhi.
Fir Ke Agge Rakhi.
Jit Dise Darbar.
Jit Dise Darbar.
Mukh ki bolan boliye,
mukh ki bolan boliye,
chit sun dare piyar,
chit sun dare piyar,
amrit vela sach nao,
amrit vela sach nao,
badiyai vichar,
badiyai vichar.
Karmiya ve kapra,
karmiya ve kapra,
nadri mukh duar,
nadri mukh duar,
nanak e vai jani,
nanak e vai jani,
sab aape sachiya,
sab aape sachiya.
How does Nanak address God?
Sahib.
Sahib. Yeah, the second word. Sahib. What is the meaning of Sahib?
Master.
So if somebody is the master, what do I become? I'm the servant. Das. I am the Das. Servant. Ego does not fall very easily when the relationship with God is of an equal, like a beloved or a lover. Yes? Ego does not fall very easily when relationship with God is of father and son. Ego does not fall very easily when the relationship with God is like mother and child. The easiest way for ego? Master, I am your servant. Finally, the ego is fully cut off. Yeah. So, Guru Nanak Dev Ji was not very lenient. Yeah. He was direct, very clear. Cut the ego completely. Sahib. Yes. And I see that Sahib in everyone. So, I am a servant to everyone, to all. With such a bhav, how can you ever have that ego? Oh, I gave you this. The moment you say, I gave you this, who's talking?
Ego.
Ego is talking. Yeah, that's why in the Gurudwara, they serve everyone. They don't say rich, poor, pretty, ugly, thin, fat, tall, short, Muslim, Hindu or Sikh. No, everybody is served free without any bhedbhav, without
discrimination.
Without any discrimination. Yeah? If I can live life like that, without discriminating at all between good, bad, right, wrong, then I have raised my consciousness really. Yes? And how can I raise my consciousness? Only after this false ego is dropped. There's no other way to raise the consciousness. If you're looking for a shortcut, I'll keep my ego also and I'll raise my consciousness. Is it possible? What is raising the consciousness?
Probably.
The self is becoming strong here. The self will become strong only when the ego will become weak. Are you getting it? That's how you raise your consciousness. He's Sahib. And he's Sacha. What is Sacha?
True.
Pure.
True.
He's the only truth, the only purity out there. His name is truth. Sachnai, Bakya Bhav Apar. His name is truth. His quality is truth. And therefore, when you think of him or talk about him, you speak with apar. What is apar? Infinite, infinite love, infinite reverence, infinite honor. Speak of him or think of him in infinite honor. Don't have any restrictions on your own mind. Don't try to see God in a form, he said. That is why the Hindus didn't want to be with him. He said, no, no, my God is Krishna. Then you've limited it. And that limitation says, now my God is better than your God. And then now I fight with you. So God is putting one person against the other. What kind of a God is this? Are you seeing this? Yeah? So Guru Nanak Dev Ji was very clear. That drop all this, my God is better than your God and I fight with you because you don't like my God. All that nonsense. Drop, 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 he said. Become very clear. No form. Beyond form. Go beyond form. So now, going forward, we will graduate in our isness meditation. We'll drop any forms that we were seeing. Suppose you were seeing Krishna in your mind and had gratitude towards Krishna, you drop form now. You expand to formlessness. Yes? If you were seeing Rama or you were seeing Jesus and you had gratitude towards that, drop formlessness. Yes? Easy? Yeah? If you're seeing anybody, any guru also is a form. Go to Guru Tattva, which is the formlessness. Yes? Higher. Now we graduate higher from here. And with infinite honor and love. Very clear? The moment I have a little also doubt about the form, it does not keep my gratitude pure. Correct? The moment I have a little also doubt, yeah? Or the moment I have this also restriction in my mind, oh, I'm a Hindu and I should think about Krishna. I've already put a boundary around my own self. Are you getting what I'm saying? Guru Nanak Dev Ji said, drop all boundaries. Open up. Full open. Yeah, the consciousness does not have a name and form. God does not have a name and form. So now, graduate. In meditation, let me just expand infinitely. Infinitely, because God does not have name and form. Super clear? Aankhe mange de de, daat kare daatar. People keep asking. Keep asking. De de. It's the same as Hindi. Give, give, de, de. And daat kare daatar? Giver keeps giving. The giver. Who's the giver? God. He keeps giving. Ceaselessly, relentlessly. Now we keep going to the temples and we keep praying, praying. What do we call prayer?
Begging.
Yeah, really begging is prayer. You are just begging from God, give me this, make this right. This is not good, you make this happen. You are begging all the time. Stop begging. He knows what needs to be given to you and what needs to be taken from you. Stop giving God instructions. You are not the master. You have started thinking, I am Sahib and God is my servant. That's why you're telling him, do this. Otherwise, why would you tell? Correct? So that ego inside has become very corrupt. That is why he goes to the temple, it goes to the church only to ask, to demand. You don't even ask, you demand. Isko theek karo. Make this right. I don't like this person. Yeah? Isko utha lo. Yeah, stop doing this. I know. I can see. Your ego has done that. Take this person away. I don't want him in this world anymore. Doesn't the ego do this?
Yeah.
There's actually a Sufi poem or something, story, in which the fakir gets very upset with his neighbor. He's so upset with his neighbor. He's so upset with his neighbor that he finally goes to God and says, see, I've never asked you for anything, but this guy cannot tolerate anymore. Please take him away. Away from this world. Keep him with you. I don't want to see him anymore. I'm tired of him. It's a story. So God talks to the Sufi fakir and says, when I am not tired of him, why are you tired? So all those people who you just wished for in the past few months or past 1 year, stop being tired of him, because God is still not tired. Whatever is hukum. Make life easy. Stop asking. Stop begging. If it is due to me, it will come to me whether I ask or I don't ask. And if it is not due to me, how much ever I beg, will it come? No. And this we know as our own experience. So stop going to God as a beggar. That's all we are doing. Day. That's all we are doing. Wake up. He knows best. He'll give you what is right for you. Just have faith. And stop wishing bad for other people if you're doing that. Especially those who keep doing it, please take this down as a homework. If it's written, no, your ego will remember. I should not be wishing bad for anybody. Anybody. It doesn't matter who they are, what they have done to. Yes, everybody write down this homework. No ill will. This is called ill will. What does ill will do? It makes my inner environment impure. Does God really take that person away? No. But inside, I have made my inner environment dirty by saying these dirty words and thinking dirty like that. So stop going to God just for asking. So then how to go to God? And if gratitude is not coming up, life is very dry, very sad. What to do? There is no gratitude coming up. Very bad. Life is horrible. Sir. Now?
Surrender.
Hukum. Just go to the temple, church, wherever you go, Gurdwara. Just sit and be in that silence. It's okay. It's bad. No, that's fine. Don't fight. You are fighting it. You know that? You're fighting it. You're saying bad itself is a fight. It is a resistance. It's an inner resistance. If outside I'm just being with it and showing that I'm being with it, does it mean I'm really with it? No. Inside I'm wishing it goes away. I have an inner resistance. So just go there and just be. Just be in the vibration of the church or the temple, the Gurdwara, wherever you go, whatever you like. Maybe in your own house you have a little puja place where you go and you sit with God. Just sit, just be in that silence.
If you don't feel like going to any of those places.
Yeah, that's fine. Wherever you are. Don't you have a meditation room or a meditation cushion? That's good enough. You might not be able to meditate with all the chaos happening in life. With all the whirlpool of thoughts. So just be in that silence. I'm not going to resist this dukkha. Dukkha and sukha come together. Again and again, remind your ego. They are husband and wife, and I'm not going to push either away. I accept this as prasad. It's tough right now, but this is prasad. Again, again, the ego will raise its hood. No, 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 but she did wrong, or he said this and she did that. And why this is happening to me only? Again, calm down the ego. How? With love, to a mischievous child, you explain things. Who's screaming and shouting in the middle of Walmart, I want ice cream. How you calm that child down? Like that, calm your ego down. That is the time you really need to calm it down. Otherwise, it's fine when things are hunky-dory in life, right? Mm-hmm. Only in that turbulent time is when that ego raises its head and starts screaming in the middle of a store, in the middle of a road. That is the time to apply knowledge. Now, in that state, you pick up knowledge, will it go in? So, in preparation for that state, what do you have to do? Start the knowledge now. Keep listening to knowledge now, so that when that ego raises his head and starts screaming and shouting, the intellect can bring out all the knowledge from the memory and calm it down. Your problem is, when the situation happens, then you remember knowledge, then you put it on. And Iktaji, it's not going in. Nothing is happening. Iktaji, what to do? Are you? Right now is not the time. The prep work had to be done. Are you understanding this? This is exam time when that problem has come into life. At exam time, you're saying, now I will start studying. No, it's the test. Now you have to answer the questions. You can't start studying right now. Are you understanding this?
To apply the knowledge.
Correct. So when do you have to start studying?
Now.
Much before the exam. Got it? And the time is now. So if you've not started knowledge, start knowledge. Regular, weekly knowledge. Come what may, now when things are hunky-dory, things are fine, this is the time I go into knowledge. It's easier to absorb now, retain and develop myself. Not when things are turbulent later. Then you do this. Then you want they, give. This is what you do because you're so turbulent. You can't understand. Meditation doesn't work. Knowledge doesn't work. Then you give up. It's not working for me. Change. You didn't apply it in the right way. Like that, you'll keep changing schools. From architecture, you'll jump to medicine. From medicine, you'll go to engineering. From engineering, you'll go to... It doesn't make sense. You're jumping. Recognize anywhere you dig a well, you will touch water. But what is the prerequisite?
To keep on
digging. To keep digging in one place. Are you getting it? So can you take the sankalpa for yourself? Yes. To start digging wherever I am. Right now. Go deeper and deeper and deeper. Finish Patanjali, go to Ashtavakra. Finish Ashtavakra, go to Upanishads or go to Narada Bhakti Sutras. Go deeper in knowledge. Then you will not go to God as a beggar. Because you'll have the solution here with me right now. I know what is the right thing to do. He'll tell us when we go ahead how you come to know the right thing. So we have to drop this asking. He gives, but we have to stop. Some people keep doing this next line. Fir ke agge rakhiye jit dise darbar. What should I keep offering him so that I see him?
What do you want?
It's a question. फिर के आगे रखिए देन फिर इज इन हिंदी फिर क्या आगे रखू कि मुझे उनका दरबार दिख जाए गॉट इट व्हाट कैन आई ऑफर हिम सच दैट आई अटेन हिम सी हिम पीपल ट्राई टू ऑब्टेन हिम थ्रू रिचुअल्स This is what Guru Nanak Dev was challenging at that time. So he said that you are offering flowers to God. What did you go and do? You went to the plant and you plucked them. They are dead now. You're offering dead flowers to God. But really, you are offering him what he has given to you.
Yeah.
It's jhuta. Jhuta in English. There is no correct translation of jhuta.
Used.
It's used. It's not original. It's not pure and original. It is used. He has only given it to you. You're offering it back to him. What are you doing? And anyway, the flowers were on the tree. They were beautiful. They were living. You kill them. Oh, people could not take this at that time. You go to Gurdwara, there's no offering of these flowers. No killing. Why do you want to kill? The flowers on the tree are already offered to him. You are offered to him already. You belong to him. You think this is you. You came by his hukum, you will go by his hukum. Whatever happens in your life is happening by his hukum. Where are you? Who you? Wake up. Tum ho hi nahi. You are non-existent. Ego is non-existent. Wake up. And now this measly little ego of yours wants to break something else, take some other life and offer to God in that lust of attaining God. What are you doing? How can you think that you can obtain God by offering something to him? And then we go and offer fruit. What fruit? He gave it to you. You offer cloth. You make that cloth from the cotton, the plant that he has given to you. What can you offer that has not been given by him? There's nothing in this universe, nothing. Then slowly when this realization dawns on you, can you become silent? I cannot really offer him anything. There is no I just bow down to him. Let me just see him in everyone, and that is the biggest offering that I can give. Yeah, that Malik, that Sacha Malik is in all, in everyone. Let me be here for everyone. That's the most I can do. There's nothing more than that I can offer. You get it? This is even one level higher than Bhagavad Gita when he said that offer your ego.
Yeah, even ego is given for
me. This, Guru Nanak Dev says, see him in everyone. As Malik, this is also 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 Malik. At your service. All the time, at your service. The highest teaching this is. He says, if you can do this, you don't have to offer the ego. The ego gets offered. Do you see how this will happen automatically? So go beyond now. Raise your consciousness higher. This begging, asking, receiving, is the lower consciousness. It doesn't feel good inside. Noticed? It feels very impure inside. Higher. We have to move higher now. Yeah. We've got a lot. Now we give. Whatever I have, I give. Whatever you can give, give. Help. Take care of others. Even just a kind word, a smile is good enough. Just give. Give. Don't hold on to things. In this giving, in this taking care, in this serving others, the ego automatically drops. Moh ki bolan boliye, jit sune, jit sun tare pyar. What words can I speak? What words can I speak that I become adorable to him? This that God loves me is such a feeling in bhakt. He wants to have this feeling. A bhakt craves for this, ki God should love me, that somehow I become adorable. God's adorable. That is why he does puja. He loves this thing. That God should adore me. And how? What should I say to God that I become His pyara? His beloved. That love wells up so much in a bhakt's heart that he cannot just be without that ultimate love. That love is what will satiate me. This chota mota love is not good enough of people's situations. He should love me. His love is ultimate. Yeah? And when you think like that, when you're in this constant remembrance of him, will you be able to do something wrong? It will stop you from doing wrong, from cheating, from even that ego coming up. You won't even say, I give when you're giving. The moment you say, I give, you will be like, oh, now God will not love me. Because my ego came up. That bhakt has that heart so full of love. He wants also love from God. You check, are you like that? It's a very Anmol Sutra. Very few scriptures have something like this. That to become God's adorable. God is my adorable is there in many scriptures, but I become God's adorable. Adore, God's beloved, God's pyara. It's such a sweet word. It just fills the heart with love. This is one of the rare scriptures that has something like this. It's not there in many other scriptures.